Coal production has contributed to Indonesia's economic growth for many years, providing revenue, creating jobs, and supporting infrastructure development. But times are changing, and reliance on coal has proven to bring economic and environmental risks. The coal sector has led to the clearing of previously lush forested areas, worsened climate change, and brought negative impacts for the environment and health, including land and air pollution, and frequent flooding. Moreover, the loss of biodiversity and failed land rehabilitation after a mine closes also hurts local farmers and fishers. Here's another catch. We also need to avoid reliance on the coal economy, which comes with some risks. Coal prices fluctuate based on global demand. Low prices often lead to pauses in production, resulting in layoffs, business closures, and unemployment. The global transition to cleaner energy will intensify coal price fluctuations and pose a more painful economic blow. So, when will the coal transition happen? At the COP28 Climate Summit in 2023, nearly 200 countries committed to transitioning away from fossil fuels, tripling renewable power capacity, and accelerating just energy transitions. Indonesia has also pledged to reach net zero emissions by 2060 or sooner, and to phase out unabated coal power by 2050. The shift away from coal to clean energy is inevitable. Some countries are already ramping up their production of the increasingly affordable renewable electricity. The global coal demand will most likely peak in the mid-2020s. The reduced competitiveness of coal plants will add to the volatility of coal prices. This will affect exporting countries like Indonesia, especially the coal-producing regions like South Sumatra and East Kalimantan. Meanwhile, international support for Indonesia's energy transition has been gaining traction, indicating the global momentum for this shift. The Just Energy Transition Partnership is a commitment from developed nations for Indonesia to mobilize $21.5 billion in funding to facilitate a just transition to clean energy, including provisions for the early retirement of coal power plants. As the transition continues, coal production will be scaled down. This means lower revenues for mining companies and potential job losses for workers across the supply chain, from mining operations to transportation and coal power plants. Without government support, this could have further knock-on effects for local communities. For example, to find new jobs, coal workers and their families might have to relocate. Local businesses, including those in hospitality, catering, and informal sectors, could lose customers as people seek jobs elsewhere. The coal transition will affect men and women differently. Women, who tend to work in the informal sector with fewer social protections, will be particularly vulnerable when coal mines close. In coal-producing provinces, the decline of the coal industry, a significant contributor to regional income, could undermine the government's ability in providing basic services such as integrated health posts, especially crucial for mothers and children. Young people may be affected disproportionately in the long term as job opportunities decline in the region. Finally, renewables and critical mineral mining projects might result in land conflicts with customary communities. But it doesn't have to be this way. A solution to the situation is economic diversification. What exactly is economic diversification? And how does it contribute to the just energy transition? Economic diversification involves identifying and developing alternative industries to coal. It also includes supporting small and medium-sized businesses and connecting local supply with local demand to strengthen the economy and reduce reliance on foreign markets. Economic diversification is key to achieving justice in the energy transition by mitigating its potential negative impacts, such as job losses and reduced national income. Some coal companies are already anticipating the clean energy future by investing in diversification into non-coal businesses, including renewables and critical minerals for energy transition. But some of these industries don't absorb as many workers as coal. so governments at all levels must step in to support alternative sectors and ensure a just energy transition. In order to achieve a fair transition, we must address several challenges. First, there is a lack of awareness and preparation for the transition. Second, national regulations are inconsistent and vague, discouraging investors from developing renewables. Additionally, local governments face challenges in energy planning due to limited authority, limited budget, and lack of specific policies at the district level. To overcome these challenges, first and foremost, we need to raise awareness of just energy transition so that people have a better understanding of this topic. Potential unemployment should be addressed with reskilling and training programs. For example, in government training centers, to support laid-off co-workers and those indirectly affected, including women and informal workers. This will allow coal regions to diversify local economies and create jobs in alternative sectors to ensure the well-being of the community when coal sector jobs decline. In addition, the national government should co-create energy transition projects with local communities and governments. A dedicated financial mechanism can further help coal-reliant regions prepare for the transition. Such support could come from coal companies through investments with a focus on environmental factors, social responsibility, and good governance or ESG, for funding retraining for miners, empowering women's businesses, and improving social infrastructure such as schools and hospitals, among others. Indonesia plans to close all coal plants to reach net zero by 2060. While this might sound far in the future, just transition measures are needed now to ensure that no one is left behind. As coal plants close, we must reskill coal workers, boost new industries, support local businesses, and invest in clean energy. This will create decent jobs and a greener future for all. Now is the time to begin.